You're watching The Big Story on Mirror Now. I'm Amita Balachandra. Let's take a look at the top headlines. No mercy for the beast who brutally raped Nirbhaya and left her to die. Supreme Court upholds the death penalty.
लेकिन सही है, आज सच्चाई की जीत हुई है. एक जिस तरह से हिंदुस्तान में रेप बढ़ रहा है उस पर एक ये करारा तमाचा है.
कलेक्टिव कॉन्शियस ऑफ दी सोसाइटी अगर शॉक करती है तो रेयर अरेस्ट और रेयर इवेंट में आता है. तो उसमें लेते हुए ऑनरेबल सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने जो हाईकोर्ट की जजमेंट थी डेथ पेनल्टी की उसको अपहोल्ड किया और इनकी अपीलों को डिसमिस कर दिया है.
The Supreme Court sets an example with Nirbhaya's verdict, says the rarest of rare crime warrants nothing short of the death penalty.
जैसे कहते थे लोग कि मैं निर्भया की तरह तुम्हें कर दूंगा, निर्भया की तरह मार दूंगा, तो आज उनको भी जवाब मिला कि मैं निर्भया की तरह अगर किसी के साथ करूंगा तो निर्भया की तरह हमें फांसी की सजा भी मिली.
And Nirbhaya's mother welcomes the verdict, says it will serve as a lesson to potential rapists.
I will not lie, today also, potholes cannot go overnight. There are many other agencies working with us. Whatever roads have been taken up for resurfacing, renovation, all those roads will be pothole free. A lot many roads have come up through the complaints which were heard from the citizens last year. Those roads have been taken up.
And a Mega Mirror Now exclusive. We follow Shiv Sena Yuva Wing leader Aditya Thackeray on his rounds of the city and ask him if Mumbai is rain ready. And another feather added in ISRO's cap, South Asia satellite GSAT-9 successfully launched from Sriharikota. PM Modi calls it a historic moment. Straight up to our big story. After 5 long years, the verdict is finally out. The brute who raped and mutilated Nirbhaya will be hanged by the neck till death. The apex court has refused to show any mercy to Nirbhaya's rapist. A special Supreme Court bench hearing the case upheld the death term passed by the Delhi High Court. The rapist had appealed against the death penalty, but the Supreme Court observed, and I quote, aggravating circumstances outweigh mitigating circumstances in this case. Offence created tsunami of shock. Nature and manner of the crime devastated social trust, falls in the rarest of rare category warranting death penalty. Convicts treated victim as an object of enjoyment with a single purpose of ravishing her. Victim's dying declaration is consistent. Offence has been proved beyond doubt and corroborated. Scientific evidence like DNA profiling of victim and accused proves to the hilt about their presence at the crime spot, unquote. Now, extremely emotional moment for Nirbhaya's parents as well. Nirbhaya's parents say that the verdict will serve as a lesson to the entire nation and that this is not the end of the fight against crimes on women.
आप लोगों को हाथ जोड़ के नमस्कार करती हूँ और बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद देती हूँ आप सभी लोगों को. आज 2012 से आप लोग पूरा समाज देश विदेश के आप लोग हमारे साथ हमारे मुहिम में जुड़े रहे. 2012 में निर्भया को कोई नहीं जानता था, हमें कोई नहीं जानता था. आप लोगों ने निस्वार्थ भाव से हमारा समाज, हमारे समाज के बच्चे, लड़के लड़कियां सब लोगों ने निर्भया के क्राइम के जो निर्भया के साथ क्राइम हुआ उसके खिलाफ आप लोगों ने आवाज उठाई, उसके लिए लड़ाई लड़ी और एक ही नारा था कि निर्भया को इंसाफ दो और उन मुजरिमों को फांसी दो. जिस दिन को हम लोगों को बेसब्री से इंतजार था, आज वो दिन आया और एक ऐतिहासिक फैसला भी आया. मैं सबसे पहले आप सभी देशवासियों को, देश के बच्चों को, लड़कियों को, सबको बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद देती हूँ. आप लोगों के साथ से आज हम अपनी मुहिम में कामयाब हुए और यहाँ तक पहुँचे और हम यही उम्मीद करेंगे कि आगे ये लड़ाई यहीं खत्म नहीं हुई, हम लोग आगे भी मिलके अपने सिस्टम के खिलाफ, अपने इस क्राइम के खिलाफ आवाज उठाएंगे। मैंने उसी टाइम कहा था, आज भी यही सुबह भी कही कि वो जो घटना हुई थी हमारे समाज के लिए, हमारे शासन प्रशासन के लिए, हमारे सिस्टम के लिए एक चुनौती थी, एक शर्मसार दाग था। लेकिन आज ये जो फैसला भी आया है हमारे समाज के लिए एक संदेश है, और ऐसे प्रकृति के जो लोग हैं उनके लिए एक सबक है। आज जिस तरह से कोर्ट में जज साहब ने फैसला पढ़ा, एक एक चीज को पढ़ा, तो मुझे यही महसूस हुआ कि देर जरूर है मगर अंधेर नहीं है। बस कोशिश हम करेंगे तो हमारी को, हमको चाहे हमारे जैसे और लोगों को भी इंसाफ जरूर मिलेगा और हम अपने मंजिल तक जरूर पहुंचेंगे।
No mercy for Nirbhaya's rapist, says the Supreme Court upholds the death penalty. Let's also listen to some political reactions that came through after the verdict.
I'm happy that the verdict has been upheld, and I wish it had come sooner, but now that it's come, I'm happy. The thing is that, you know, in this 5 years is not a long time by legal standards in India. Some cases, I know one murder case which has just been decided after 34 years. What I have done is, in which women can get better justice, is to start one-stop centers called Sakhi. Now, these are 150 centers now, and we are trying to get up to 600. And when women get anything from molestation, stalking, rape, domestic violence, kuch bhi, any problem with them, they can go to these one-stop centers and they will be provided free legal service, free police service, psychiatrists, doctors, nurses, and hundreds of women now are going to them. So this is one big step that we have taken.
बिल्कुल सही है, जिस प्रकार का ये हादसा था और देश के इतिहास में शायद ही किसी महिला पे इस प्रकार का अत्याचार हुआ हो कि जिसने पूरे देश को हिला दिया, और सख्त से सख्त इंसान के आंखों में भी आंसू आए और गुस्सा पैदा हो, इस प्रकार की ये घटना थी। पूरा देश उसे हिल गया था, और मतलब जज के आंखों में भी पानी आए, इस प्रकार की ये घटना है। और निश्चित ही निर्भया को मरने के बाद भी कहीं न कहीं न्याय इस फैसले से मिलेगा, और उनके जो माता पिता है उनकी भी यही अपेक्षा थी। उन्होंने तो यह कहा है कि इससे भी कोई सख्त अगर सजा है तो वो मिलनी चाहिए। और समस्त महिला वर्ग की ओर से मैं ये कहना चाहूंगी कि कम से कम ऐसा वर्डिक्ट आने के बाद अब तो महिलाओं पे अन्याय अत्याचार होने बंद होने चाहिए। ये जो गैंग रेप्स है और इस प्रकार की जो मानसिकता हो रही है कि सिर्फ रेप करना ही नहीं मगर छल करना, शरीर के साथ खिलवाड़ करना, ये कहीं ना कहीं रुकना चाहिए।
Activists in the meantime who've been voicing their demand for the strictest punishment for the convicts is set to proceed and are certainly happy. Listening to some reactions.
आज सुप्रीम कोर्ट के जजमेंट पे गौरव हो रहा है कि जजेस ने जो है महिलाओं की सेफ्टी के लिए हिंदुस्तान में इस डेथ पेनल्टी को अपहोल्ड किया है। पहले तो डर लगा कि शायद ये स्प्लिट जजमेंट में कहीं कुछ और ना आ जाए, लेकिन सही है, आज सच्चाई की जीत हुई है। एक जिस तरह से हिंदुस्तान में रेप बढ़ रहा है उस पर एक ये करारा तमाचा है, एक कड़ी रोक है। क्योंकि अगर आज डेथ पेनल्टी निर्भया के रेपिस्ट को नहीं दी जाती तो ये हो जाता कि महिलाओं को कोई सेफ्टी देने वाला नहीं है, प्रोटेक्शन देने वाला नहीं है, और वकील जो है वो किसी चीज को तोड़ मरोड़ के सामने रख देंगे और बड़े से बड़ा खूंखार रेपिस्ट बच जाएगा। आज न्याय की जीत हुई है, कानून की जीत हुई है, और सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने डेथ पेनल्टी दे के ये साफ कर दिया कि वो देश की महिलाओं के साथ है, देश की बच्चियों के साथ है।
The Delhi Commission for Women welcomes this particular verdict. It is something which was very important. The Supreme Court today, by giving death sentence to all the rapists of Nirbhaya, they have in a way emboldened all the Nirbhayas in this country and given a very tight slap to all the rapists. This was something that was needed. It was the need of the hour. A very strong message has been delivered by Supreme Court that if anybody rapes a woman, it will not be taken taken lying low, and the Supreme Court in the country would support Nirbhaya's.
Now, the Nirbhaya case verdict is a historic moment for women all across the nation who are feeling unsafe. What relevance does this verdict hold in the legal term? Some expert opinions coming your way.
Well, the Supreme Court has applied its principle of rarest of rare cases, the facts of the case, and come to the conclusion that capital punishment was warranted. I'm sure the court has gone into all the factors. We can't go by people's sentiments in this matter, by certain principles. The women's safety lies in other factors. Question here is narrow question. What is the punishment to be imposed on those people who have been convicted of murder? Is that case falls in the category of rarest of rare? Then it's a different matter. If it doesn't, different conclusion follows.
जिस एग्रेवेटिंग और ब्रुटैलिटी से ये क्राइम हुआ है इसका ये रेयरेस्ट ऑफ रेयर केसेस में आता है. ऑनरेबल सुप्रीम कोर्ट की जो पहले की जजमेंट है जिसमें क्लियर लिखा है कि कलेक्टिव कॉन्शियस ऑफ दी सोसाइटी अगर शॉक करती है तो रेयरेस्ट ऑफ रेयर इवेंट में आता है. तो उसमें लेते हुए ऑनरेबल सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने जो हाईकोर्ट की जजमेंट थी डेथ पेनल्टी की उसको अपहोल्ड किया और इनकी अपीलों को डिसमिस कर दिया है.
5-year-long wait finally ends. Supreme Court upholds death penalty. But 5 years after Nirbhaya case, Mirror Now did a ground check, and this is what we found. Women across the country continue to feel unsafe.
Absolutely no safety, because when you travel to different places or wherever you go, it's always that you need to stay conscious, you need to be careful about what's happening around you, and that's because you're women.
I feel like women should know how to carry themselves at public. They can have a pepper spray with themselves, they can learn self-defense.
I think it should start with school and colleges, where you should not restrict the boy and girl, like you shouldn't talk or you shouldn't touch or sexualize. There should be restrictions, but not like having a bar and a bus to avoid girls and boys talking.
I feel death sentence is a very short-term solution. I mean, it's like आपने एक हम कहते हैं ना कि retribution का एक यहाँ पर हम लोग देखते हैं कि एक death sentence दे दिया and you feel that your responsibility is not over. Police officials feel now since they have got the culprit and now they have punished the culprit, the responsibility over. But the responsibility does not end there. We have to ensure that in every case, like every a case that has happened with a minor or a case in which a person is talking about. The accused is a politician or the accused is a very higher official.
It is called rare of the rarest case, right? So yeah, the convicted, I mean, those people shouldn't be left.
Half of the population, if we see, is women. And if there is no safety for women, then I don't think so that there will be any progress or any growth in our country.
As a student, I'm very happy with the verdict that all the 4 rapists are to be hung. The concept of fast track courts is somewhere lacking over here. And the family of the victim has to wait so much and go to the courts and wait for the hearing and the decision. So this verdict, nevertheless, it has came late, but it is for the good of the society.
So I feel this is a correct thing they've done, and this would have done in the before, because they've taken a long time to decide and say they should be hanged now.
I think it should have done before only. They have taken so long time to decide.
I think this is really good. I don't think these people deserve to live, because they can't respect life clearly, and they've also shown that they have no remorse for what has happened. So I think this is a good decision.
A historic verdict which we were all waiting from for 5 long years, and we can say that now we can believe the law, and this is something which was needed so that there is something like people get scared.
Supreme Court upholds death penalty. This is a historic verdict for women across the country. The brutes who raped and mutilated Nirbhaya will be hanged by the neck till death. The apex court has refused to show any mercy to Nirbhaya's rapists, and a special Supreme Court bench hearing the case upheld the death term passed by the Delhi High Court. Away from that story now, moving on to some news from the city of Mumbai. Mega Mirror Now exclusive. We follow Shiv Sena youth leader Aditya Thackeray as he reviews the road construction across the city of Mumbai. The 26-year-old politician has been travelling across the city talking to contractors and workers on the progress so far. Thackeray visited 10 spots including Gateway of India and Churchgate Station to take an update on the road repair work.
It's 1 a.m. in the night and the Shiv Sena Yuva Chief Aditya Thackeray is out on the streets to check on the progress of the pre-monsoon road repair work. And this is, of course, the second spot, the second place that he has visited this week. He has targeted South Mumbai areas starting from Gateway of India and right up to the last spot, that is the Shiv Sena Bhavan in Dadar. Of course, he has assured that the citizens in the city of Mumbai will not have to face pothole riddled roads. And as you can see, of course, the work also, the road repair work is going on in full swing, at least at this point in time, because he says that this is the only time available for the workers to work. Of course, we know for the fact that the ground reality at this point is very different. Only 34% of the pre-monsoon road repair work is done. And lastly, BMC's mayor, Mumbai Mayor Vishwanath Mahadeshwar, says that if any contractors, if they fail to meet the deadline, then legal action will be taken against them. This is Isha Shah for Mirror Now. The monsoon is just a month away now, and we know for the fact that this year around, do you see that there's a lot of progress in the road repair work compared to the last year? Because this time we have seen a lot of issues that have cropped up. I mean, contractors have refused to work. I mean, not working, lack of raw material. There are a lot many issues. But what do you think, is Mumbai rain ready for this year?
As you firstly said, monsoon is a month away. I really hope it is a month away, because we do not want a year reeling in drought again, because our farmers suffer, the entire state suffer. And yes, about monsoons, of course, I will not lie, as we've never lied before. I'm not saying all potholes will vanish overnight. There are 16 agencies working in Mumbai on roads and various other things. But whatever the works have been taken up in the last 5 years and this year itself, if you see all those roads that have been resurfaced or relaid, they are pothole free. A lot of junctions, for example, a lot of pothole prone junctions earlier, like Worli Naka, Juh JVPD junction, Mahim Church junction that had potholes earlier, they are pothole free. Similarly, the roads taken up right now, you can see there's progress in work. We went to western suburbs day before yesterday. Today we've come here in the city, and maybe tomorrow, day after, go to the eastern suburbs to check the progress with the engineers, with the mayor, leader of the house. We're seeing the progress, we're seeing the hurdles, hearing firsthand from them what they're facing in terms of work. And of course, one of the most important hurdles we're facing right now is a lack of raw materials, because the quarries have been banned. We've appealed to the Chief Minister to help us through that, because now the decision is at his level. We face two cases. One is an affidavit in the court where we have to commit a certain number of roads to be finished. The other is the NGT, which has banned the quarries. So we've requested the Chief Minister that till 31st of May, we need the quarries to be working so that the raw materials are in place, post which we can shift. The other issue about Mumbai is, of course, floods. But if you see over the last 4-5 years, Mumbai has moved from flooding over 2-3 days, like other cities have, to something which is called waterlogging for 10 minutes and not beyond knee level. Because of the geography of Mumbai, lot many areas are under sea level. Mm-hmm. High tides and heavy rains, when they coincide, we'll have waterlogging. But because of the Brimstuart project, which is at Hindmata, which is Britannia, Love Grove, Irla, and now Gazdarbandh, which will cover Juhu, Andheri, Bandra West, Santa Cruz area, we have the capacity of throwing out 36,000 liters of water per second. So the pumping stations will help Mumbai to be flood-free.
And lastly, we know for the fact that every year extensions after extensions has been given, to the contractors, to the workers. After 15th of May, the contractors, workers, they don't finish the trenching work. Is there any penalty for the contractors?
See, of course, there will be penalties. There will be questions asked and investigations carried out. But also, there's a practical difficulty even in roadworks. A couple of people say that we need longer stretches to do work. The permission from the traffic police is only about 200 meters. So to cover up time within that, if a larger stretch is dug up, it's done faster. 200 meters is a short stretch to be done, and therefore that's where the timing issue happens. But our plan is to complete as many roads as possible.
This time around, any special provisions to address the citizens' complaints, and within what time the citizens' complaints will be addressed by the BMC?
As I said, I will not lie, today also, potholes cannot go overnight. There are many other agencies working with us. Whatever roads have been taken up for resurfacing, renovation, all those roads will be pothole free. A lot many roads have come up through the complaints which were heard from the citizens last year. Those roads have been taken up.
In other news now, while Maharashtra faces a severe drought situation, netas in the state continue to splurge a 16-member delegation, including two ministers, legislators and presiding officers of the Maharashtra legislature, have left for a 14-day study tour. And the study tour will go to places like Australia, New Zealand and Singapore. Each member will incur a cost of more than 6 lakh rupees towards airfare and accommodation. The state legislature is expected to incur the cost of more than 30 lakh rupees. The latest is what we hear from is a former Maharashtra Chief Minister, Prithviraj Chauhan, has written to Prime Minister asking him to recall all the netas who are on the junket.
The Prime Minister must recall his ministers immediately. They can go later if they want. And money is not an issue at all. A state of Maharashtra can easily afford the cost of 6 lakh per person or whatever. It's a timing. You left the state in a dire strait, the whole state is agitating, farmers are continuing to commit suicide. What message are you sending to those farmers that the agriculture minister and food and civil supply minister has gone on a junket to destinations?
This is not a travel junket. This is a parliamentary committee of the Commonwealth that every year ensures that it invites legislators from different political parties. So the representation is from Congress, from NCP, from BJP, from Shiv Sena, and all these parties are invited to attend. There is no money to be borne by the exchequer, and it is for obviously better dialogue and better coordination of how system should function. I don't think there is any need to correlate this with agrarian crisis. We understand our responsibility.
Also on the show, Haryana's MLAs want a huge hike in salaries. The Haryana Salaries and Allowances of Ministers Amendment Bill 2017 was passed in the Haryana Assembly, which has resulted in 100 times increase in the MLA's allowances and a manifold increase in salaries and perks.
आज विधानसभा का विशेष सत्र 4 मई को हम लोगों ने बुलाया था और विशेष सत्र बुलाना पड़ा था. जीएसटी का जो हमारा स्टेट का बिल पारित करना था उसके लिए विशेष सत्र था. आज सर्वसम्मति से जीएसटी का बिल पारित हुआ है और साथ में ही 3 यूनिवर्सिटीज़ के बिल थे वो पारित हुए हैं. कुछ मंत्रियों के और साथ में स्पीकर, डिप्टी स्पीकर और लीडर पोजीशन, इनके सैलरीज का वेतन का जो बिल था वो पारित हुआ है.
Moving on now, police in the dry state of Bihar want you to believe that 9 lakh liters of alcohol was consumed by rodents. That's what you heard just now. After bottles of seized liquor went missing from police godowns, the cops cooked up an incredible story of how liquor-loving rats drank it all. That's what we're hearing. This is an extremely interesting story here and coming from Bihar. Police in the dry state want you to believe that 9 lakh liters of alcohol was consumed by rodents.
Of Bihar, which says that rats have destroyed the liquor in the malkhana.
But sir, it's been said that the SSP of Patna, Manu Maharaj, held a meeting with all the SHOs, and there it's been said that the SHOs had come up with certain figures and data and said that liquors have been destroyed or consumed by the rats in at different police stations. Now, how true is this, sir?
We will look into the matter.
But sir, now the reports coming in and visuals shown on television clearly show that an SHO of a police station is creating nuisance after consuming liquor. Then yesterday we had seen how police jawans consuming liquors in police headlines were arrested by the SSP himself. So where is this liquor coming from? Is it from the seized or the confiscated liquor?
No, it's not confiscated liquor. You see, in a society such big as ours, there could be persons committing wrong also. The issue is that what action and what response we are undertaking. In all the cases which you have just referred, the response of police has been very prompt, and not only departmental action initiated against them, but legal action has been taken. They have all been arrested and sent to jail after registration of case.
In fact, Sham joins us on the phone line with more details. Sham, alcoholic rats in Bihar. Is this story for real?
Well, absolutely. It's been said that the rats are on high spirit here in Bihar, but the Bihar police denying this thing, saying that nothing such has happened. When I spoke to the ADG headquarters, SK Singhal, he clearly said that no such incident has happened. But it's been said that, yes, around 9 lakh liters of alcohol has been missing from all the godowns across the state. Now, these liquor were the confiscated and seized liquor, which were caught here in Bihar after Bihar was declared a dry state. But as of now, police are denying this thing, saying nothing such has happened. But sources within the police clearly say that, yes, an order has been initiated into this to find out as to why, how come these some amount of liquor has been missing. It's been said that some policemen have been caught drinking inside the police lines, and we have even shown visuals of how these policemen were drinking and creating a drama. But as of now, police say that nothing such has happened, but sources clearly say that an order has been initiated.
Also, Sham, tell us, why has this story been cooked up in the first place? Has investigation begun already?
Well, yes, investigation has begun, but it's been said that it's cooked up just to hide the facts, because the SSP of Patna had ordered all SHOs to give him an inventory of how much liquor they had seized and how much liquor is still in their godowns. Now, it's been said that the policemen posted in these police stations were either consuming the liquor which was seized by them, or they were selling it to some other people in their locality. Now, when this came to light, it is being said that these SHOs were given a dressing down by the senior police officials. And after this, they came up with a new theory that the liquor was destroyed by the rats, because it was these liquors were seized since last year when this liquor law had come into action in Bihar. So now, to save themselves and the SHOs and the police officials to save themselves, they came up with this new theory and new story saying that the rats had destroyed the liquor which was kept inside the malkhanas, which is the godown inside the police station. But yes, an order has been initiated, and it's been said that the police will very soon come out with these things. The SSP had ordered all SHOs to take strict actions against police officials who are caught either drinking inside the police station or in their locality.
So Bihar police there saying that rats consume 9 lakh liters of alcohol. Thank you so much, Sham, for getting us those details. Investigation, of course, is now underway. We're going to keep a very close watch on this story for you. With that, it's a wrap here on The Big Story. Stay with Mirror Now.